Hey everyone, and welcome back to our channel. We appreciate all of the support, feedback, and video suggestions from all of you. We're glad you're enjoying the content. Today, like last week, we're going to cover a topic that was requested from one of our subscribers, and that is the difference between demand shocks that shift the curve, also known as a change in demand, versus a shock which moves you along the curve, also known as a change in quantity demanded. With that said, let's get right into it. So if you have any knowledge of basic economics, then you're familiar with the concept of supply and demand. The supply and demand curves are plotted on a graph with price on the vertical axis and quantity on the horizontal axis. The law of demand states that as prices increase, quantity demanded decreases, hence why the demand curve is negatively sloped. So what causes a change in quantity demanded? Well, any change in the price of the good or service. Typically, as the price of the good increases, you would demand less due to the law of demand. This would imply a movement to the left along the demand curve. Well, that seems pretty easy. So if a change in the price of a good changes quantity demanded, causing a movement along the demand curve, then what constitutes a change in demand or a shift in the entire demand curve? Well, that would simply be all factors that are not a change in the price of the good or service to the consumer. We've summarized all of these shift factors up to a list of five: income, prices of related consumption goods, consumer expectations, tastes or preferences, and population. Now let's explain what each of these shift factors means and provide a few examples. So let's start with income. The higher a consumer's income, the more that the consumer can purchase at any given price. We call this an increase in purchasing power. So therefore, if we're plotting an individual's demand curve, an increase in income would shift the demand curve to the right as people can purchase a higher quantity of the good without a change in the actual price. However, this does depend on the type of good. There are two types of consumer goods which determine if income increases or decreases demand, and they are normal goods or inferior goods. For normal good, if income increases, you demand more of the good. Most goods are like this, so most goods are normal goods. In the case of an inferior good, if income increases, you demand less of the good. Well, why would that work? Isn't that the opposite of the law of demand? Well, think of an inferior good as a good that you buy that you don't really like. However, you buy it because you cannot afford anything else. When your income increases, you will demand less of this good since you can now afford more expensive goods and the goods that you actually enjoy. The second shift factor is prices of related consumption goods. So goods can be substitutes for each other, they can complement one another, or they can have no relationship to each other at all. Substitutes are goods that can replace one another because they are so similar. Complements are goods that tend to be used together. Let's take a look at an example of each of these types of goods. A great example of substitutes is Coca-Cola and Pepsi. You will consume one or the other, and assuming that you have no taste preference between the two beverages, you will typically buy the cheaper option. For example, in the top graph, we can see that the price of Coke has risen from $2 to $3. So on the top graph, the graph for Coke, there is a decrease in quantity demanded due to the change in price. But notice on the bottom graph, the graph for Pepsi, there is an increase in demand. So the entire demand curve shifts to the right. This is due to the fact that in our example, Coke and Pepsi are substitutes. So if the price of Coke increases, people will substitute away from it and start to consume the relatively cheaper option, in this case, Pepsi. Alternatively, we could have two goods that are consumed together, such as ink cartridges and printers. In the top graph, the price of printers increases from $250 to $350. So we see that there is a decrease in the quantity demanded, so therefore a shift along the demand curve to the left. This is caused by the change in price of printers. Since ink cartridges are complementary to printers, you will decrease the aggregate demand for them, which shifts the demand curve for ink cartridges to the left. The third shift factor is a change in consumer expectations. If the consumer thinks the price of a good is going to increase or decrease in the future, they will increase or decrease their demand for that good today. A great example for this is gasoline. If it's Thursday and you're driving home from work, school, the gym, or wherever you spend your Think Econ Thursdays, With less than a quarter tank of gas, and you hear on the radio that gas prices are expected to increase by 10% by the weekend, you will likely choose to fill up your gas tank immediately at the cheaper price because you expect prices to increase in a couple of days. On the other hand, if you hear on the radio that the gas prices are likely to fall by 10% on the weekend, you are more likely to not stop for gas and get the gas on the weekend instead so you can take advantage of that cheaper price. Make sure that you don't confuse this with a change in current prices. A change in current prices would simply lead to a change in quantity demanded or a movement along the curve. The fourth shift factor is a change in consumer preferences. For example, if something like advertising steers consumers' preferences towards a good, then demand for that good will generally increase. Preferences can also change over time, such as the types of items you would put on a grocery list now versus when you're older. Finally, we have the fifth shift factor, and this one is pretty simple to remember: population. So the more people, the larger the market, which shifts the demand curve to the right. The less people, the smaller the market, which shifts the demand curve to the left. So to summarize everything we've talked about in this video, a movement along the demand curve is caused by a change in price of that specific good or service. A shift in the demand curve is caused by any of the five shift factors: income, prices of related consumption goods, consumer expectations, tastes or preferences, and population. So there you have it. Now you know the difference between a change in quantity demanded, or a movement along the curve, and a change in demand, or a shift in the entire curve. If you like this video and are excited to see more, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.